Hello everyone, LRon here with part 4 of my OT8 guide. So, up at the top of the ladder there, that's a spot where I usually would save on this map, practically regardless of what I'm doing. For whatever reason, I don't end up saving there. I don't think I save at all on this map, so that would have been a good saving spot. So, luckily it was around the right time for me to cut off the video too, so... that would have been your safe spot, probably. That was the bulk of the work. There's only a little bit left now, but if you need to save earlier, that's fine. Usually, I'm able to take care of this guy a little more gracefully. He usually doesn't notice me, and then I jump over the hill like I did. Well, this time, he noticed me. So we gotta just hide behind this corner and mow him down. So right now we're at that point where we do have enough ammo to play around with. So we can start to consider doing cool stuff. So here's some of that long range headshot stuff that I've mentioned before. I did get hit with that shot, but it was at such a range that I took very minimum damage. Because you're using, like, shotguns and machine guns. They're rarely using pistols at me, so I've got, A, the advantage of using pistols, which travel far well, and, B, I'm actually going for the head instead of some random location. So, back to some of that catnip stuff I was mentioning before. If you hide off your catnip before entering the brewery, you get to keep all that catnip. And then all of the catnip that you get from the weekdays go away when you start Apocalypse Weekend. So I end up having a ton of catnip at the end of the weekdays. So feel free to basically use them at will during the weekdays. You're going to need to be a bit conservative on Apocalypse Weekend because I found 6 in my run, and 4 of them got dedicated to the Kosher Mad Cow God from Hell. Although it looks like 3 can be done if you're as efficient as I was in October. So that only leaves you with 2 to 3 catnip spare in Apocalypse Weekend, unless you can find more catnip than the catnip that I collected during this run. So I guess the moral of the story is, on the weekdays there's a ton of catnip that I'm not using, and so you should be using it, because that just makes your life a lot easier. So, we are now finally at the glorious moment where we can ditch the shovel and the taser. And we're going to move on to some real stealth melee tools. First, we're going to keep this dog happy. It's good to keep the dogs happy, otherwise they don't do anything. And in some cases, they'll start fighting again. So we pick up the butterfly knife, and we get to test it out. Butterfly knife is a one-hit kill on stealth attacks. There are exceptions. Most cops tend to not die in one hit, so whenever we deal with cops, I'm usually using a silenced shotgun, because that is a guaranteed, you know, 2 or 3 hits. Instead of the butterfly knife, which is practically negligible damage if you're not getting a stealth one-hit kill. So, repeatedly just stabbing and stabbing and stabbing is never going to get anything killed. So then we open up these doors and pick up the pistol. And then we're going to... pick up some ammo in the bathrooms, and then go over to our next catnip location. So technically, I only need 2 catnip in the course of my weekdays, but I show, you know, pretty much all of the ones that are not super out of the way, because catnip can be extremely useful, especially to help those who happen to be worse than I am. And so, you know, I don't consider myself to be a super skilled gamer. I dispelled that delusion about a decade ago. And so, you know, I realized that, you know, I'm just a normal guy who likes video games. And aren't particularly good at them. So catnip will help bridge gaps. It bridges the gap for me in 2 locations where I can't just tough it out. And then for you, there's plenty more catnip to go around to bridge even more gaps if necessary. This room's a bit annoying because there's 2 patrollers. I usually try my best to stealth at least one of them. Then usually it fails on the second one because the second one notices me as I kill the first or something along those lines. So there it goes. I make my way out here and then get ready to mow down. Probably not the best to waste ammo from this weapon. It's such a trivial thing, but
I feel better already.
Sometimes when you're in a pinch, because you see, I use the scroll wheels, so pretty much when the time comes, I just use whatever's in my hands at the time. So anyways, we are now going to rob the bank. We're going to take the back entrance in through these sewers. So in the original version, the one with the bad recording settings, I have an outtake that's interesting. Basically, it shows that if you were to use a grenade on that bookshelf there, you can actually open it up. So you technically don't need to depend on others. But we just do a couple shotgun shots because they're worthless. Already maxed out on them. And then we're gonna let someone else open the door for us. And then we're gonna mow them down, quickly jump through. And we're gonna clean up the mess. We're gonna hide on this side of the door. That way the door acts as part of a wall. It's a good way to keep a good angle and get an edge over them. I kicked all the furniture out of the way so that things are a little easier with the gasoline, so this is going to be one of the gasoline areas. It doesn't really work out the best for me because the mobs came in a bit slower than they usually do, so they were able to avoid the fire altogether. So only a handful of mobs got in flames. Oh, that's probably it there. I didn't go as far out as I normally did, so that was why. You probably wanted to have the gasoline go further down the hallway. Alright, so after the cutscene, this video will end. I will see you next video. Good luck, have fun.